Hi everyone, back again. This time I want to talk about Three Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri, which is a movie that's been out for a while now, I think, and I just happen to have been able to see it now. And it really sucked because I can't believe I've waited this long to see, in my opinion, one of the best movies of the year. I thought that this was fantastic in terms of character, in terms of acting, in terms of how unique it is. I think that it's really one of the best films of the year, not just for my entertainment, but also just as a movie. I think that, to me, that falls in both categories, where there's movies I love that might not be great, but I think that this one is one that falls into both those categories. Like, this is a fantastically written movie, and these characters are fantastic, and the story is fantastic, and the acting is phenomenal. Frances McDormand, I haven't seen all of her movies, but I think she's really a fantastic actress. I think she's, like, I love her in Fargo and, like, Burn After Reading. I think she is legitimately really good. And in this movie, and like I said, I haven't seen all her films, but this might be my favorite role of hers. I think that she brought so much to this role, and I really love how she, in terms of the writing, too. She and her character have so many layers in terms of how you learn so much about her. But I love too that this is a character that, with a lesser like screenwriter, it could have gone wrong in terms of this character being a bitch or a horrible person. And this character is a horrible person. And I like how this movie has almost all these characters are horrible people. Like, they have so many things wrong with them. And it follows a very, very interesting line between loving and hating these characters because they do awful things, like terrible, shitty things, but you care for them. And I love when a movie can do that. Her character, Mildred, especially, the way that she is such a badass, but she's the badass that I love, in which it's a character that is strong and is cunning and is somebody who is fights against everybody, but I like how she's got flaws. That to me makes a badass. I feel like a badass that has no flaws and is nothing, to me, is not a great interpretation of a badass character. And I think this is fantastic. I loved how strong she was, but I liked how she had so many flaws, and you learn them along the way, but they cut deep, these flaws and how she is to other people in this story. I love how it changes between how horrible she is, but you find bad things that happen to her, but it's not like you're condoning it. You're looking at it from both sides, but the character was so well written, and the acting from Frances McDormand was fantastic that it made me love this character so much, and I think it's great, again, that you can follow a fine line between a person being super shitty, but you can still love this character. I really do love when they can accomplish and attempt that, and they did such a great job with that. And in terms of the other two big actors in this movie, Sam Rockwell and Woody Harrelson, I think that they did a fantastic job as well. I think that Frances McDormand probably had one of the best roles she's ever had in this movie. And I think that Woody Harrelson and Sam Rockwell, just like when they're really great in their other movies, are fantastic in this. I think that they both are really great characters and they did great, had great roles in this movie. And I thought that they really, really sold it. I like how Sam Rockwell is this, his character Dixon is this cop who does a lot of crooked things. Like, he is very, very crooked, in which, can't really explain it here without spoiling it, but he does a lot of irredeemable things, and a lot of things that you're just watching the movie, you're so surprised at how much he can get away with, and it's interesting to see his transition. Like, he has a great arc in this movie, the way that he starts and the way he ends. No spoilers, but it is fantastic. And Woody Harrelson in this movie is fantastic as well. has this interesting guy who, to me, this one's hard to not, I can't really talk about this one. This one's really hard not to spoil. So, I'm just going to say that he's great. He's a great character in this movie, and I thought that he is hilarious and he is interesting, and I liked how his relationship with all the other characters works really well, and it's really interesting the way that the story follows along with him in it. I think that it is really cool with him. But the story is really interesting too. I like how it's a story of this woman who her daughter was raped and murdered, and she is mad at the cops because the cops aren't doing anything, and I like that you see the sides of the cops, too, because, yeah, the cops are crooked, but I like that whenever they have the talk with Mildred, whenever Willoughby, Woody Harrelson's character, talks to Mildred, he is saying to her, like, we did everything we could, we couldn't find any fingerprints or anything, there's nothing else that we could do. So I kind of understand, even though the cops are crooked, I understand that they can't do anything else without legitimate proof, but I love how Mildred is so pushing to find the person who raped and murdered her daughter, and I like how there's no evidence for it, and I like how she goes and tries and gets more pissed at the cops and goes drastically, or pulls more drastic measures as the movie goes along. And I love, too, how chaotic the movie is, and the movie is very great at a build-up. Like, it is very interesting in how it starts out and then it ends, and it builds up so much between the characters, the rage, the anger, and the emotion towards all these characters and all these events that happen at the same time build up to, like, they keep escalating, and I like the way that it escalates. It's really interesting showing how chaotic these characters can get. Like, this is what I mean by these characters being really shitty people, and they are, but they're so likable because of the actors, and the writing. It feels like they're so likable still, but I like how they all keep, with all these circumstances, keep getting more and more angry at each other, and kind of it escalates in such an interesting way. It really is interesting in how it evolves the characters. All three of them do have an arc, and I think that it's really interesting in how they all are different arcs. They all have some reason by the end to have this full story arc, and they all feel really warranted by the end whenever the resolution happens, and I really thought that was great. But like I said, it's just a fantastic movie in terms of the characters, in terms of the acting, in terms of the story and the writing. These characters are so interesting, but they're so horrible, and they're so likable, even though they're so horrible, and they're so funny. And this is a really, really, really great dark comedy. The darkness aspect of it is dark and brutal and grim, and it's really hard to stomach sometimes, but I like how the jokes in the movie don't ruin the tone. They just make it a really good dark comedy, and I think that it's interesting to laugh at such horrible circumstances with these characters, which they kind of put themselves in, and because they're shitty people, but I really liked that too. I thought that it was a great dark comedy, and it worked so well on every level, and I thought that this is one of the reasons why I watch movies. This is one of the reasons why I watch movies with great characters, with a story that's interesting and different, and something that has such likable characters, even though they're shitty. And I like whenever a movie can follow a fine line between those two, between liking them so much, even though they're terrible people. It's great, and I think it's a fantastic film, and it's in my top five of this year. I think that Frances McDormand deserves an Oscar nomination. And I think Sam Rockwell and Woody Harrelson are fantastic too. I think they deserve something, but if it was up to me and one of the three would get a nomination, it would be Frances McDormand, because I think that she is the one that has the most emotion, and I think that carries it a long way more than the other two characters, which were great as well, but they don't have as much of an emotional level in terms of their characters. So, but I hope that this wins awards. I hope that this is remembered. I hope that people will go see this, because this one was fantastic, and I'm so glad that I wasn't disappointed. I'm so glad that we got another great movie with these great actors who have time and time again proved themselves to be really great. And like I said, Frances McDormand, probably her best role that I've seen her in, and I haven't seen all her movies, but, and Woody Harrelson and Sam Rockwell are fantastic, but the movie overall was fantastic, and I loved it so much. But anyways, thanks guys so much for watching. Check out my other stuff, and I'll talk to you next time.